At last the noise grew so loud that he lost patience, and he stooped to pick up a stone to hurl it into the midst of the clamor, when suddenly his arm seemed to stiffen, and the next moment he was a stone himself. That day his sister, who thought her brother's steps were long in returning, took out the knife and found the blade was red as blood. Then she cried out to her brothers that something terrible had come to pass. "I will go and find him," said the second, and he went. And he walked and he walked and he walked till he met the giant and asked him if he had seen a young man traveling towards the mountain. And the giant answered, "Yes, I have seen him pass, but I have not seen him come back. The spell must have worked upon him."
"Then what can I do to disenchant him and find the water of life, the talking bird, and a branch of the tree of beauty?"
"Follow this path, and when you reach the mountain, you will find it covered with stones. Do not stop to look at them, but climb steadily on. Above all, heed not the laughs and scoffs that will arise on all sides and never turn round. And when you reach the top, you can then take all you desire."
The young man thanked him for his counsel and set out for the mountain. But no sooner did he reach it than loud jests and jibes broke out on every side and almost deafened him. For some time he let them rail and pushed boldly on till he had passed the place which his brother had gained. Then suddenly he thought that among the scoffing sounds he heard his brother's voice. He stopped and looked back, and another stone was added to the number.
Meanwhile, the sister, left at home, was counting the days when her two brothers should return to her. The time seemed long, and it would be hard to say how often she took out the knife and looked at its polished blade to make sure that this one, at least, was still safe.